Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Tonight we're going to look into how we can validate a request, a JSON request that is sent to us in our Spring Boot application. How can we validate that against a schema? And then pass a response. We can throw an error if the schema is not valid. How can we do that? Which frameworks should we use? And let us just get started. So I've already created a Spring Boot project right here. I created it by pressing File, New Project. And then I chose Spring Initializer, SDK 15. And then I chose Gradle just because I preferred Java 15. Next, I ticked off Lombok and I also selected Spring Web like this. Next, finish. And then I ended up with this project right here. But then I had to choose because I needed some kind of library that could actually test a schema against test some JSON against the schema. And first of all, of course, we should have a schema. And I've created this schema right here. This is a Corona passport request that the schema is applicable for. And it has two things. It has a person and has a passport. And you can see that in the bottom right here. Here I have a reference. Here are the properties. Means I have a person right here. And the definition is a reference to the person, which is defined under definitions right here. And they are both required. So this means that if I did not validate the JSON against the schema, then JSON would just try to convert as much as possible into an object. And I will show this in just a while. But first of all, let us just look at the person. The person has a name. It has a name with the type string. It has a social security number, which is not required. I'll show you that in the bottom. Then it has a type string, and then it has an age, which is an integer. And required fields are name and age. Then there's a passport. This is a Corona passport. It contains some information about if the person has been vaccinated, if the vaccination process has begun. Boolean, it's a Boolean. And then also if it has ended. Usually the text to vaccination injections to actually be vaccinated totally. So that's why there is a begun and ended right here. Then we have a tested negative. That means that if the person has been tested and has been tested negative, that's also quite good. And maybe this will also be a part of the passport and allow this person to participate in a big computer arrangement or something like that, a big conference with Java or Spring Boot, right? Then we have a test date here for when the person was tested the last time. And then we have has been sick with Corona, again, a Boolean. And the required fields are begun, ended, vaccination process, tested negative, has been sick with Corona. So those are the mandatory fields. And none of these would be mandatory if we just converted with JSON and if we just converted to to an object as usual. Then that is why we need the validation against the schema right here. Then I've created Java classes that matches this. I have a Corona passport request right here, and then I have two fields right here: passport and person. And the passport is created right here, and you can actually see the fields. They actually match the schema that you just saw before. Vaccination process begun, ended, tested negative, tested the test date, has been sick with Corona, and the same with person, name, social security number, and age. And see here, I have camel case right here, and then I have kebab case. That is the name for it. I have kebab case in my schema. You can see here, I have dashes. I like to have dashes in my JSON. I don't know why, but anyway, I'm going to use that. And that means that I have to set my Spring JSON property naming strategy to kebab case in my application properties. So I did these things. And what more did I do? Yes, then I had to find a framework that could actually validate JSON against my schema. And what did I do? I went to the JSON schema webpage, JSON schema webpage, and then I searched for implementations. So this means that if you are using another language than Java, then you can actually find some. And this is the first match up here, JSON schema.org. and then implementations. Then if you scroll down a bit, a little bit right here, you can see here there are implementations for .NET, for C, for C++, for Clojure, for Go, for a lot of cool stuff. And then we come to Java. And the one that I would recommend is the one called Network. This is the one in the bottom right here. I was in and checked how often these were actually updated. These projects were updated, and the network NT, the JSON schema validator, was actually there was a commit like 8 days earlier than the date where I actually checked it. And another thing, they are bragging that they are much faster than the other. Than the other libraries. I have not tested this myself, but they are bragging that this is much faster. I have no reason not to believe them, or else I guess someone else would have said that this is not true. Then we have the dependency that we should add. It's right here, and I'm using Gradle, so I need to add this dependency right here. And that is exactly what I have done. So let us go look at that. I have my... Here I have my dependency. This is my com network NT. JSON schema validator, and the reason why I also like to use it is actually because it can actually validate a JSON node, which is part of the Spring framework because it's JSON. And I'll just show you that in just a minute. I have a REST controller right here, and this REST controller, I have created a post mapping. You can see here I've annotated with REST controller, of course. Then I've given a request mapping of API Corona. And then I've created a post mapping with no validation first. So first we try with no validation, and what actually just happens right here, JSON will convert the JSON into an object of the type Corona Passport Request. But what that means is actually that it will just take all the fields that it can, then it will convert it. Let's say it gets a string where the content of the string is true. Or if the content, then it would actually just convert that to a Boolean automatically without any hassle. And that is good sometimes, but in our case, we want a strict check. If someone sends in a string in a Boolean field, we want an error instead, because it could be a mistake, right? And the same with age. If someone gives a string when age should be an integer, then we want our application to puke an exception, right, and give an error. That's what we're doing down here. But up here we just get map it to the Corona Passport Request, and we map it as well as Jackson now knows how to do that. Let us look at the codes that where we actually validate something. First of all, request body, now it's type string instead, because that we want the whole JSON string as a request body like this, because then we can actually take the string, and then we can actually validate it against our schema. And what do we do more? What else do we do? We actually, first of all, we want to get our schema as a stream, and the way we do that is by getting the class loader. We get the resource as a stream, and that's because I've placed this schema under resources model, and then Corona Passport Request schema.json. So that means that it's part of our project. It's part of what we are deploying on our server. Then I create this nice schema from it, and this schema right here, we go up a bit, JSON schema. You can see this is from the network. You can see these are the special classes that we actually got from the library that we imported. We are using JSON node, which is from the JSON library, and that is pretty, I think it's pretty awesome. It works just so well with this network NT library. Okay, so what do we do? First of all, we create a schema, get instance, and this I'm using schema version 7. If you don't know what the version is in your schema, then you just double click your schema, go up in the top, and you can see right here up in the first line, it says schema, and this is draft 07. So that means, of course, that we also are using version 7 right here, right? And then we say get schema, and then we give the stream the schema as the stream. There are many other ways of actually creating the schema with. There's a lot of factory methods. You can try them out yourself. You can also point to a file directly, I think. There's many ways to do this, but I like my schema to be a part of my project. and to be a part of what I actually deploy. And this was the way that I chose. Then we create an object mapper. This object mapper is the JSON object mapper. So of course, since we are not using the object mapper, which is created by default by Spring, then we need to set this property once again. This could have been done in another way, but I want to be explicit in this example right here. So I am writing this once again. So I set property naming strategy to kebab case. Then I create a node from, I say here, I take my object mapper right here. And then I say read tree. That means I'm actually creating a JSON node from my string. And this node right here, it has nothing to do with the original Corona passport request. This means that this is just that this is a JSON node. So that means it will actually it will actually represent the JSON exactly as it was posted to us up in this string right here. And that means that then we can actually get all the errors when we try to validate it. So first of all, then I just say schema.validate and then my JSON node, which is a JSON class. I'm really, really impressed with this validate right here. You can see here it takes a node. Cool. I'm very, very happy. And then I get a setback with validation message. I get all my errors back. And what do? I loop through all of my errors and then I build up an error string. I was actually thinking about creating a good response instead of just returning the object, and I could return a good response to the client where it says, these are your errors, please fix those. But instead, I was lazy, I just threw a runtime exception. That means that when a runtime exception happens inside the this post mapping, what the client will actually receive is just an internal server error, and it doesn't say much. So the client will not be helped very well. We have to go look in the server log in this example right here. Feel free to change it so you actually return a response right here with the errors and maybe also with the object that we actually create right here, if everything works fine. So if we have errors, we puke a runtime exception. If we don't have any errors, then we create our Corona passport request by using the object mapper that we defined up here, the object mapper up here. Then we say read value, and then it actually converts it into the Corona passport request, because now we have validated that everything was actually fine. There was no errors. And then I log that what we're returning, and then we return the request. Now let us try all of this. So let us press play first and see what actually happens. I have prepared some cool curl scripts up here. We are running on port 8080. The application is starting up. I am trying to, maybe I should go up in the right. Let me just check. Top. Is it better if I go up there? We'll just see. Because now we want to see the because now we want to see the output. So this is the server output. My server is now up and running. First, we try without the validation. See, this is the no validation. And I have created this passport1.json right here. And look at this message JSON here, right? My age is a string. This should have been an integer, right? But I'm still posting it as an integer. And what the JSON does along with when I post this to my Spring endpoint, it actually just converts it to an integer. It just says, okay, it's a string, but I'll just try anyway to convert it. And this is why we need the schema validation, right? Then we have a Boolean right here. Test a negative, true. Test date, this is just a string, this is fine. But here now again, it has been sick with Corona. This is a string again. And we are also missing some fields in this passport right here. But first of all, let us see how it looks in the no validation version right here. Here you can actually see we got a nice Corona request created right here, where we have a passport and we have a null for the fields that we have not mentioned. Then we have test negative, true, that's a Boolean right here. Here we have the test date that is a string. And again, we have has been sick with Corona false. That means that it actually converted the string successfully to a Boolean. Then we have the person named Mike, social security number null, and age 80, which is an integer now. And that is because I am printing out, if I go back to my code right here, then I'm printing out the request right here. And a request has this a data annotation, which gives it a good to string method. This is why we got the, we get this to good to string method on the Corona passport request. So far so good. So now we try it without validation, and it was a bit of a mess, right? So we did not get all of the we did not get the required fields filled out. Now let us try with validation. With validation, and again we try with the same sucky JSON, and there are so many errors in it, so we just run, and look what we actually got here. As we got returned status 500 internal server error, and this is because I puked the runtime exception up here. So here we have the runtime exception. But before that, let us look at the errors. Look here what we got. Now we have a list of errors. First of all, passport vaccination process ended is missing. But it is required. Yes, this field is not there. Okay. Has been sick with corona, string found, boolean expected. Yes, it is the wrong type. Thank you very much, network library, for actually validating this. Person age, string found, but integer expected. Yes, again, it was the wrong type. Now let us try to fix these things together. Copy. I'm going to copy this. And then we call this ad hoc fixed, because we are fixing it right now. Together. So okay, so let us look at the first one. So this is missing, but the field is required, so let us copy. This was under passport, so this was the first complaint we got. And let us say vaccination begun. Let us just say that's the true. Then we got an error regarding this type right here. It was the wrong type. Then we got an error regarding this type up here is wrong. And I think that was actually it. So let us try to take this with validation. We'll also copy that script. Copy validation. We call it ad hoc. And instead of posting passport one, then we post ad hoc fixed. Let us try that. Run. Oh, again, we got an internal server error because now we have some other. Now we have some other errors. Let us look at those. Okay, I made an error in my Jackson. Yes, I need a comma right here. Again, thank you very much, Schema, for pointing out my failures or my errors. let's just take this one right here again. Ad hoc fixed. Let us run this. Again, we got an internal server error, so we have to go and look in the server log. What is wrong right here? Please fix your JSON. Oh, is missing and is required. Vaccination process ended. We forgot that one. Copy. Ad hoc fixed. Ah, yes, we forgot that. We forgot that, sorry. And we say this to true. Let us run, let us just clear this again. And then we run this one right here. And again, we got an internal server error. Let's go on the server side. No, we did not get an error. We got the object back because now, of course, there was no errors. So we actually got the object returned. Passport, yes. And if we go look at the log, look at this beauty right here, this beautiful Corona passport request right here. We have the vaccination process begun, true, ended, yes. We have, has been sick with Corona, false, person, Mike. Social security number is not necessary because it's a private information, right? So I just left it out, that's why I left it out. And then we have H80. This is awesome. I hope this actually answered your question. There was a lot of questions about how to in your Spring application how to validate the incoming JSON as, and let me just go down here again, how to validate your incoming JSON against the schema before actually dealing with it. So this, you can see we have these two ways right here. You could of course also just accept anything like this. And then you could create a validation method that then complained and puked when the fields were not filled out, for instance. That's also one way to do it. But you can also create a nice, the nice thing about having a schema is that you can be more expressive. You can also express regular expressions, and you can also give this schema as a contract to whoever you cooperate with, whoever is going to be the client, and then they would understand exactly how to create the JSON for you, and they will be much happier than just than you just telling them that you should send something like this. It's much better with a schema. Then you have a contract, fixed contract. It's a good, it's also a good dialogue tool when you are designing your service. But here we have it. It's quite easy. First of all, we create our schema. We have an object mapper where we create the JSON node, and the JSON node is a good representation of the JSON right here. And then we ask if there's any errors, then we puke, and we also print out all of the errors, of course, and then we return the real object, and we convert this with the JSON also manually if everything is fine. I hope this answered your question, or else just feel free, as usual, to ask me more questions. Thank you very much for all of your comments. They always make me happy. Have a great evening. Bye-bye.